What's up, Internet? Senior Whoopi here, and welcome to another Days Off video where today I'm not actually... It's not really a Days Off video, I'll take that back. This is just a E3, things that you might have missed, recap kind of video. I have been watching almost non-stop coverage of E3 brought to me by the wonderful people at Rooster Teeth and Funhouse. Both those companies are related anyway, so like if you like one then you should definitely check out the other. But I was able to basically live the E3 experience without ever leaving my house this week, so it's been a huge week. Let me go in my garage, please. Yes, please, thank you. All right, so the week started out before the E3, or if you're wondering what E3 is, it's the Electronic Entertainment Expo, so a little trivia there. But the week started out on basically Sunday, where Bethesda had their zero day, or it was like minus one or whatever. This started before the actual events started. So what Bethesda, like the stage they announced on, was glorious too. The event was really good. Well put on, people of Bethesda, if you're listening right now. Perfect. It was a really good show. But I think most of these games I have listed here were announced at that event, but I could be mistaken, so... I mean, I've just been throwing this stuff together. It's just me working as a journalist. I mean, these mistakes happen sometimes, so anything that I mentioned today that you might be interested in, go seek out some more information on, feel free. I'll definitely have links in the description to just about everything that I talk about today. But yes, let's start out with Bethesda. Bethesda held their press conference before anybody else and really hit it out of the ballpark with the things they announced. I'll list some of the things that they announced that that weren't so great first. Dishonored 2? Well, not so great. Don't hate me for that. It's just... these are games that I feel like deserve an honorable mention, but I probably will not play. I played Dishonored 1 for like 15 minutes, didn't really get into it. I don't know. I'd like to go back to it one day, but it's like, what's the game I'm trying to think of? Oh my god, what is that game? It's not Fallout. No, don't want to spoil that. God, what is the game? Bioshock? I think it's called Bioshock, yeah. Yes, it's Bioshock. Dark Souls, Dishonored reminds me of Bioshock a lot, so didn't really like that game and might not play too much of it, but hey, it was announced. People apparently want it. So that's a thing, and it's been announced. Another thing that they announced, at least I really hope it was Bethesda because I have listed under them, was Dark Souls 3, another game that... It's just not my cup of coffee. It's a game that deserves an honorable mention. A lot of people are very happy for it, but I myself probably won't play it. But hey, it's a game. It looks pretty, that's for sure. Other than that, they announced Doom, which out of the other games that I've mentioned, Doom looks like a game that I might actually play. Super gory, giant guns, the BFG, you know, just like really cool stuff. After that, they announced, hey, fuck you. They announced some stuff for a new card game. It's supposedly a Hearthstone killer, if you can believe that. It'll be called Elder Scrolls something. I actually didn't get that information. I forgot about that. But, it's the Elder Scrolls card game. So, if you're interested in that, look for that coming, later this year. Oh, damn! Where's your turn signal, fuckhead? Fuck you. Anyway, at the end of the event, they decided to get that perfect mic drop moment, and they announced Fallout 4, and everybody just lost their shit, just like, ah! So, Fallout 4 is announced, they showed gameplay, they've talked a little bit about the story, the origin, like where you start out and all that shit, and where you make your character, so that's cool. They also announced a special edition that comes with a real-life Pip-Boy, except this is something that I still just don't understand. It's like, it's a second screen kind of Pip-Boy experience. You have to have a iOS or Android device to stick in the Pip-Boy to then operate the Pip-Boy. That makes very little sense to me, because all phones are bigger or smaller. That just seems like a nightmare for development teams, when you could have just put a little shitty screen on there. Not shitty, make it nice at least. It's for the special edition. But yeah, having people control it with their phone is going to be tedious, and every time your phone rings, you're going to have to answer it and put that stupid Pip-Boy up to your face to talk. So that I can see being kind of a problem, but for some reason the fans are extremely eager to get their hands on one, because in my research I found out only a few websites have them for sale right now and don't say sold out. So if you want your Fallout 4 Pip-Boy and you got $300, which is what it costs, go order that shit now. So that's cool. But that comes out November 10th as well, of this year, 2015. So that's also extremely cool. People lost their shit for that as well. So look forward to that in the later part of 2015. Something else that the developers, Tom Howard, was the main guy who talked on stage for Bethesda and also talked at Microsoft, but we'll get into that more when I talk about that press event. But at the end of this press event, he said that he knows that people have been waiting for a very long time. Oh, I knew my car was just a little too wide for that jump, but I was like, oh, I'll try it. Anyway, at the end of this press event, he announced something really cool, which was a mobile game that was free to download, and you could download right now. And of course, everybody and their mother went to go fucking download that game. And I was really surprised. I was able to download it on day two. It took me only a day of waiting to get the game to download. And that tells you anything about my internet, it's shit. So, yeah. But I'm going to talk about that for a little bit, because I actually downloaded it and have been playing it, and it's very, very fun. I'll quote the good NerdCubed here, and he says, the game does one thing right, and that's the how they handle their microtransactions. So, fucking props to them. I agree completely with NerdCubed in this, is they don't have any game-breaking mechanics for DLC. Basically, you play the game, it's like Weird Sims? I don't even know if I want to call it that, but you... God, people, stop talking. I'm trying to talk here. Anyway, you build a Fallout shelter and you give people jobs. That's basically it. But it's based on minutes and time and stuff like that. There's even some rooms that take hours. It's ridiculous. But they're like really powerful things that you get after that hour. It's like more dwellers, vault dwellers, I think the game calls it. So those take a really long time. But I played that game. I've had two different vaults, and the first vault just failed awfully, really bad, failed so badly. And vault two, the second vault I had, lasted a really long time, almost 2 days, until I was playing Xbox or PC or something, and I was playing that at the same time, and I wasn't paying attention, and then all of a sudden I had, you can have, like, things happen to where you need your vault dwellers to act and either put out a fire or fend off raiders or destroy raid roaches that, or rad roaches or whatever they're called, that come and try and destroy your base. Not really destroy, but they just wreck shop whenever they come in. All production in that room halts, and they run around like chickens with their head cut off. So it's bad. It's bad when it happens. And I was slightly paying attention. I started sending people to the room to destroy the raid roaches. Then all of a sudden the raid roaches spread to every room in my vault, and I lost about 17 people that day. So that was my last experience with that game. I put it down since then and have not played it. But the way they do their DLC, not DLC, the way they do their paid bit of the game is when you complete little objectives, it's almost like achievements. I really like it. You get caps, which unlock rooms and things like that, which you can use to build rooms. I'm sorry. To unlock rooms, you have to have dwellers. And you can, of course... Oh, yeah. to the achievement things. Whenever you get achievements, sometimes it's based on some, or sometimes you get caps, and sometimes, whoa, damn lag spike there. That was really strange. But sometimes you get caps, and sometimes you get these things called lunchboxes. And lunchboxes include cards that can be anything from food, water, or power, which you have to have a certain amount of all three at any given time to run your dwellers properly. And sometimes you'll get in these cards special weapons, gear, or special dwellers. And I was able to pull, like, two special dwellers in some of the free lunchboxes that I got. I still haven't paid any money into this game, even though I really thought hard about it. The first mobile game I'd ever spend money on being this game wouldn't make me feel that bad, because it's Bethesda, and any money that they get from this game, I hope they just use it wisely, because they're going to be making a lot of money. But anyway, yes, that game, sadly, is only available on iOS devices. So you have an iPad, you can play it. You have an iPhone, you can play it. But if you have an Android or Android-based tablet, which like 70% of the fucking gaming community have, you cannot play this game. At least not right now. I think they've said that they're bringing it to Android users, but Apple was just better at what they were doing to help them bring it out on that announcement day, on that press event day. So that's really cool that they were able to say, oh yeah, this game that we're announcing, it's available now, go download it, yeah. So that is awesome. I love it when developers do that and they don't flop the game completely. So Bethesda, big thumbs up. Your press event was wonderful, well presented. Less talk, more video gameplay and stuff like that. Perfect. Mwah. Grade A presentation. But maybe I just have like rose-colored glasses, because that was the first press event that I watched, and I was like, my hands were twitching, waiting for news and awesome stories to cover and stuff like that, like I'm doing now. So it's awesome. And I watched the Funhouse guys cover it and talk over it and commentate over it, so I learned a lot about stuff like that. If you're interested in that, their video, 7 hours long, you can watch that. I don't think they covered the Bethesda event, though. They might have. But, yeah. Anyway, that was day zero. Long day. Lots of stuff going on. There's a race in the middle of the road back there. Strange. Anyway, day two moves on and opens up with Microsoft. Microsoft comes on stage and just starts blowing people away with, one, their stage. It's fucking amazing. Best looking presentation stage out of all the other events. Sony was pretty good, except they had like this weird screen right in the middle of their shit. Didn't really like that. It's really odd. But anyway, Microsoft came on stage and announced a lot of brand new IPs. I kind of feel like I should mention those first, just because let me scroll down here. Pull over the side of the road. Okay. All right. So the new IPs that Microsoft announced that will be on their console include ReCore, which is like they showed some cinematic trailer for that. It looks really good, but it's just cinematics. Kind of strange. You take a core out of a robot and put it in another and accomplish tasks, I guess. So that's interesting. Gigantic, I believe is how you pronounce it. Kind of like, I don't even know, kind of like shaded, cell-shaded, that's the word I'm looking for. Kind of gameplay, it's a hero brawler, I believe, so that's interesting. If Smite appeals to you, that might be good for you. Ion is from the maker of DayZ, so we don't know much about that game except that it's set in space, in space stations, maybe? Maybe it's DayZ in space on space stations? That would be cool. And other than that, they announced, of course, their main exclusive titles, which include Halo 5. They did some gameplay of that. Four people on stage playing it at the same time. Looks meh. And if you know me, I love Halo games. Except here lately, my love for the Halo franchise has just been run straight into the ground from Halo Reach started the downfall, Halo 4 was just, I don't know what the fuck they did with that story. And then the Halo Master Chief Collection was like almost the final straw that broke the camel's back. It was so bad, and it's still broken to the time that I am announcing what I'm announcing today. So yeah, it's still a piece of crap, 343. And you're gonna make Halo 5? What the fuck? But yeah, they have gameplay for Halo 5. Looks like you can stay in a party, at least while you're on the E3 stage, but whatever. Anyway, Halo 5 is another story entirely. I might buy it, I might not. I would probably not, though. Until I see for sure that it works. But when you play Xbox, if you don't play Halo, you're left with, like, a small list of titles. Anyway, what else was announced? Forza 6 was announced with a new Ford GT will be in it, so that was kind of cool. They lowered a Ford GT from the ceiling to announce that. Alright, more power to you. After that, what did they announce? Oh, a game called Beyond Eyes. The developer came on stage and was talking about it. It's a game about a blind girl. It's got this weird watercolory texture where the girl walks around and she uses, like, what I'm only assuming are Spider-Man senses to tell what's around her. But they showed the last bit of the weird gameplay trailer was a girl getting attacked by a wolf or something, and she could see the wolf popping in and out, she could see the wolf's face or something, and then she just fell over. And I was like, so how do you fight the wolf? But anyway, that might be good, that might be shit, who knows. Let's see, I'm jumping around. Tomb Raider's not an exclusive, but they announced it there. Cuphead. Cuphead is like a 1930s side-scrolling boss beat-em-up, maybe? We'll see how that looks really, really good. And more on the games, more games, more games. Oh, the guy from Tim Howard, I think was his name, the guy from the Fallout guy, came on stage and talked a little bit about Fallout. I can't remember, I didn't write this down, but he might have said that there might be exclusive content for Xbox. That might be wrong, I don't know. But I know the fact that he did announce that he's working with people at Microsoft to bring mods to the Xbox version of Fallout 4. So that's cool. That's really cool. But if we have to pay for these mods, and that's Bethesda's way of getting around paid mods, because people fucking bitched whenever paid mods came to PC. They were like, hell no, we'll donate to the modders, but we will not pay for this shit. There's just no way. Is this real game content? No. We're not going to pay for it. So, if Bethesda's using Microsoft as an outlet to try and push more paid mods, then this will be a bad thing. But if not, then this is a very, very, very good thing. So, we'll just see what the future holds on that. Let's see. Some PC games that are making their way to the Xbox include DayZ, which... Oh! Sorry. Terribly sorry. But DayZ, which looks good. Who knows? I've always kind of wanted to play DayZ, but I've never got around to downloading it. But, yeah. Ark Survival, which is really amazing how quickly that's moved from PC to Xbox, because, like, only in the last 3 months have I seen major Let's Players playing it and streamers playing it, so... Wow, that picked up speed really quickly. So that's coming to Xbox One, so if you're excited for that, woohoo! Other than that, they announced a lot of hardware that'll be for the Xbox One, which include hardware chain. Somebody's placed a bounty on me. What the fuck? Anyway, thank you, Jonathan Zayas. Yeah. They announced hardware changes. So it's a software update for the Xbox One, and it's available now for preview members. The backwards compatibility is now a thing, and I think that was the best mic drop of the whole E3 event. I just want to say that really made me go, yeah! So, backwards compatibility is coming to Xbox One. That is really fucking awesome. But, the list leaves a lot to be desired, but I guess they're trying to change that because on the Microsoft forums they have a little list made by the developers, or the dev team of this, they're asking people to vote on what titles they want to be backwards compatible, so they don't waste their time making backwards compatible titles that nobody will play. At least that's the way they explained it, but there's no truth to that, because the titles that are available now for preview members, which I'm an Xbox preview member, so when I get some time, I have a day off tomorrow, so I might record some Xbox 360 games then. I just need to download them. My internet, again, terribly slow. But yes, if you're a preview member, check for that update and check for these games. These games won't be listed in the game store. They'll be listed on your available to download now list, which is really strange, hard to navigate. I don't know how to get back to it because I've removed one of them from my list thinking it was not, like, I thought there would be more titles, so I removed one hoping another one would pop up, and it didn't, so now I regret that because I don't know how to get it back. But anyway, the list of titles include things like Viva Pinata, World of Keflings, and Toy Soldiers. Games that I have, but I don't give a fuck about these games. Like, why the fuck did they put their time into this? I don't know. But anyway, they're having people vote on the next few titles, and what's winning right now is things that you'd expect, like Skyrim, Red Dead Redemption, Fallout 3, so things like that. Halo titles, Halo Reach, things like that. So that's just really cool. Thank you, Microsoft, for announcing that. But please hurry up on bringing us more titles. That's all I gotta say. But yes, the hardware they announced was a new controller. I've heard people reference a controller next to like a SCUF controller, and I did my research. I found out what SCUF controllers were. It's basically like moddable, customizable controllers for PS4, Xbox 360, or PS3 and Xbox 360. And this is basically an Xbox One more updated version of that, and more beefier. It looks better made, and working on, I've customized a few Xbox 360 controllers, and I've seen how people can customize the Xbox One controllers, and they're extremely bare and basic on insides. These controllers seem like they're going to be a nightmare to fix, but I'm slightly interested in it. I'm not interested in the $150 price point that they're set at now. So, yeah, I'm going to wait for that to go down in price. But yes, in the middle of the event, though, the last thing that I'd like to mention for hardware, I don't think this will be coming to Xbox, but it might just be a Microsoft thing, but who knows? It was in the Microsoft press event. It was the HoloLens demonstration, where they strapped a HoloLens on one of the dev team and strapped a HoloLens on a camera and showed people a perspective of what the HoloLens looks like. And oh my god, it's fucking amazing. Virtual reality has been kind of hot this year, and people have been talking about the Oculus Rift, which actually announced a consumer version, which would be launching later this year, I think, or maybe Q1 of next year, who knows. But yeah, that all fell by the wayside when people really got a look at HoloLens. With they showed Minecraft in this demonstration, and I wanted to cry. It looks so fucking beautiful. Not to mention, it's the fucking future. So if you haven't seen that, please go watch some stuff. They had a commercial months ago talking about the HoloLens and what it could be, but a commercial's commercial. They can render things and put things where they want. This was on stage, live, at a press event. It looks fucking good. It looks really fucking good. Not to mention that Microsoft had a booth with this in it, and I've heard everybody from Funhouse and Rooster Teeth talk about this Minecraft, and they also had like this cool Halo 5 environment thing that you could do, where you walk down a hallway and it's got like the HUD heads-up waypoint thing on your visor. So that's so fucking cool. That is so fucking cool. That is Master Chief technology in like our time. I'm at a loss for words. It's fucking cool, and I cannot wait for that. So HoloLens, if you haven't seen it, go check it out. But yes, that is all that I have. They also announced that Xbox is going to be having a early access thing kind of program coming to Xbox One. Is this good? Maybe. Is this bad? Maybe. There's been lots of problems with this kind of early access thing on PC, and I am to expect to have just the same amount of problems on Xbox One, except Steam and PC have a now refund thing that you can go through and get your money back. As far as I know, I don't know if I can get my money back on an Xbox game. I've never really tried. So this early access thing might be a bigger problem for Xbox members who pay into it and then are extremely disappointed with the outcome of, like, or what they get, the product. They might be really upset with it. How are they going to get their money back? I don't know. And will the developers have to shell out money back to customers? I don't know. So that could be either heads or tails. We really don't know right now. I guess we'll find out shortly whether or not that's a thing. Looking at my map now, I think all the other players have left because I'm just driving around having nothing to do with people. Nah, anyway, that I believe is all I have listed for Microsoft, which started out the day Monday. After that, this was like, there was four press events on Monday. After that, they had the EA press event, which was really good. I also watched that through Funhouse, so props to those guys. EA announced quite a lot of stuff, but everybody was waiting for Star Wars Battlefront. I have fucked that up every day this week, just because I have this like thing in my head. I know it's being released and published through DICE, so Battlefield 4 is the first thing that comes, or it's Battlefield. Anyway, Star Wars Battlefield, it's the thing, it's coming. It looks really good and it sounds really good, but I've heard people just say some things that make me go, they might be right. I'm just saying that it looks really small maps, really kind of tight everything, just not good tight either, so that's at least Nerdcube. He says that he's not happy with it, and I don't really see why. It's just because, I don't know. I'm a really big Star Wars fanboy, so I really was excited to hear about this and to see actual gameplay that looked so fucking pretty. It looks like the fucking cutscene, so if it looks like that on Xbox One, I'll be very happy. If it looks like that only on PS4, I'm gonna be really pissed off. But yes, it took them an hour and a half to actually get to that point where they showed bits and pieces from Star Wars Battlefront. And before that, they also mentioned a Star Wars something-something card game. I didn't get the name. I think it's called Galaxy Heroes? But it's a card game. Yeah, another Hearthstone killer. We'll see. Hearthstone's great, so fucking bring it on, EA. But yes, they also announced, or teased, I should say, a new Mass Effect game. People lost their shit when that happened. Looks really good. It looks like what No Man's Sky wants to be, and I'll talk more about No Man's Sky in just a minute. Oh, damn it, I hit the car. Damn it. But yes, what else did they announce? They had a good almost 40-minute area where they were just talking about sports games. Of course, everybody knows that there's going to be another sports game, and the people that are at these events aren't there to see sports game stuff, so why they went so heavy on it, I don't know. But the most memorable bits from the sports game thing that they were talking about was, one, they had a Pele interview, an interview with the soccer player Pele, talking about FIFA, like that's an okay thing to still talk about. But yeah, it's Pele on E3 stages. What? Anyway, I watched this through the Funhouse bit, and I could barely hear what Pele was saying, so I don't know what he was actually interviewed about, but the guys at Funhouse were just like, oh yes, Pele, I kicked the ball and I never looked back. Ah! So I laughed my ass off at their jokes and stuff and barely listened to the interview. But it was there and it was a thing. So, EA, what were you doing? But other than that, they had another thing where they showed off a new facial mapping camera app for NBA 2K16. So they had this guy come on the stage, and his name was Da Hoop God, and apparently they had made this guy up just for the E3 event. The guy had no Twitter followers, but at the end of the little thing where they did the face mapping thing and let him go off stage, they're like, yeah, go follow at Da Hoop God. And I was like, what? So if you look the guy up, he now has followers, but at that time, he had no followers. So again, EA, what the fuck are you doing? Do you know how to have press events? You include game footage and you talk about games and that's it. Anyway, they also announced Plants vs. Zombie Garden Warfare 2. Alright, Plants vs. Zombie Garden Warfare 1 was good enough to get a sequel, I guess? I don't know. Best part of that, they had Danger Zone playing in the background. Anyway, they played it 2 times in 1 day, too. Oh, fuck you, guy. I hope you're dead. Run me off when I cut red lights, or run through red lights. Anyway, they also announced the new Need for Speed game, which doesn't look half bad, but the way that the camera was moving in the drift sequences really made me nauseous, and I hope they get rid of that, and I hope they change that. EA, if you're listening, fucking change that. But yeah, that's basically all I have for EA. After that press event ended, Ubisoft had a press event, which they started out with some weird live-action stuff, which played on their browser, channel. All these press events were actually accessible from, like, Microsoft's was from Xbox.com, EA's was on EA.com, Ubisoft was on Ubisoft.com, but you could also watch all of them on Twitch and YouTube, so it was all over the place. So if you missed it, like, the content's there, just Google it. All you have to do is Google Ubisoft and you can watch the whole press event. So, really cool. But Ubisoft, they started out great with the announcement of South Park, a new South Park game, which they didn't show any of the gameplay, but if I'm thinking correctly, they just remake South Park Stick of Truth with a different skin over it, then it'll be good. Hold on, I need a beverage. I've been talking for a minute. But yes, the South Park game, not only does it look like a South Park episode, which is awesome, but they gave it a fucking glorious name. The game is going to be called South Park Fractured Butthole. And it's spelled like B-U-T space H-O, no, W-H-O-L-E. So, it's really fucking funny. So I hope that nothing weird comes up and they have to change the name, because I love that name. It's great. I'll actually keep this title and won't resell it just to keep this on my shelf. But yes, that was like as soon as their press event came on screen, that was what they announced, and I was like, yes, this is gonna be awesome. And they led on to be pretty good in the Ubisoft thing. They had Alicia Tyler, which is the voice of Lana from Archer, which at first I didn't recognize her because I was watching this while I was at work making pizzas, and I was like, is that really? No, that can't be. But it turns out, not only is it her, but she's done this many times. So this is the first press event, like, where I've been able to watch all the press events, thanks to YouTube and Twitch. I couldn't do it without you guys. But anyway, Alicia Tyler was there. She's great. She was a wonderful presenter. I want more presenters like her. But yes, they went on to announce a bunch of different games, and they had a bit where there was somebody singing for the Just Dance release, which there will be a new Just Dance game. Woohoo! But they had some thing where some guy that I didn't recognize was singing. It was really skippable, so if you get into that part, you just skip it. But they also announced a really cool 4v4 sword fighting kind of game. It's called Fort Honor, which really looks good. It looks really pretty, and you can pick not only samurais, but you can pick warriors and Vikings and stuff like that, all from that kind of time period, and you have them fight 4v4. It's really cool, with like AI people in the middle where you could just slice them into bits. And so that looks fucking good. That was a brand new IP that Ubisoft announced. Also, they showed some gameplay from The Division, which basically looks like Destiny set in, like, it looks like apocalyptic New York City. It definitely is New York City, because the cop cars say NYPD. But what really is strange is that people are just walking around the streets with AR-15s and collecting loot and stuff like that, but lights are still on. It's just really strange. Like, how far... I want to know more about the story. It's really what I want to know. It's Tom Clancy's the Division, so I'm going to keep my ears open for more of that and maybe do some more digging and come back to you guys with more facts on that. But that game looks like a pretty good game. If you like kind of Destiny slash leveling up looking for loot, then this will be cool. It also has like some weird betrayal aspect in it to where you can kill the players and take their loot. So that I don't like, and that I would not like to see anytime soon. Oh, damn it, fuckers. But yes, let's see. After that, they also announced Rainbow Six Siege, which looks really good. It looks really good. They also had, what was it? There was another game. Oh, it's called Ghost Recon something something. I wanted to call it Ghost Retail Cartel, because you're fighting like Mexican cartels and cocaine runners, but that's definitely not what it is. But that game looks good, whatever the title is. I don't have that information in front of me, I'm sorry. But yeah. They also announced a new Trackmania game, so that looks really cool. Not only is that like the, you can drive in loop-de-loops with F1 cars and drive on walls and stuff like that, and upside down. So that game's always been kind of piquing my interest, but this one has a lot of map editor stuff in it, so that's cool. Not only that, but it has a random map editor, so it's like, oh, I'm tired of all these racetracks, let me just randomize one. That's really cool. I've never had a racing game that could do that, so I'm interested to see how that's going to work out. And of course, the final thing that Ubisoft announced in their mic drop was Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which I like some Assassin's Creed games. Assassin's Creed 2 was so good that I got all 1,000 gamer points on it. I got a 100% in that game, collected all the fucking feathers and everything. But for some reason, I just can't get into any other Assassin's Creed game after that. Assassin's Creed 3, I played like 15 minutes and put it down. Assassin's Creed 4, I played like 15 minutes and put it down and haven't been back. I don't know, there's something that I just don't click with like I clicked with in Assassin's Creed 2. But this game, Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which is to be set in like Victorian London, it looks like this game might just click with me. Oh yeah, I didn't play Unity either, Assassin's Creed Unity, I didn't play that. I just heard the horror stories of how it was broken. I was like, yeah, I'm not buying that. So, fingers crossed that this Assassin's Creed game works and is good. So, yeah, that ended the Ubisoft press event. And we'll scroll down here. We have the Sony press event came on into the day, which I have to say, when you're choosing press events, you want to go first. You don't want to go last, Sony. I don't know what made you pick this time slot, but next time, try better. Anyway, they started the show out with one of their bigger mic drops, which is The Last Guardian. And I've never played any of the games from these makers, the makers that also made Shadow of the Colossus. I've watched people play Shadow of the Colossus. Nerdcube has a really good playthrough of that if you want to watch that. I'll try and leave that in the description if I can. But anyway, The Last Guardian. People went fucking nuts. So that game's finally announced with gameplay, no less. I think they said sometime 2016. I'm not sure. But yes. They also announced another game from the makers of Killzone. It's called Horizon. Something Sky? I'm not sure. But all I can think about is how many times the game Forza Horizon is going to come up when people Google search for this game. Oh, fuck you, guy. Yeah, anyway. That game looks really good, and it's a PlayStation exclusive, so I'm really sad that I'll not get it. But, yeah, other things they showed on the stage was No Man's Sky. Looks really good. Now if they'll just, like, give us a reason of why you'd want to play this game, because, I mean, other than exploring, I don't see why people would play this game. Like, I don't see what the point of the game is. Like, do you collect minerals? Do you, like, discover things? I'm really unsure as to what this game physically is. So, other than that, it's just, like, fly around in a spaceship. You can battle people in space. Space battles is pretty cool, but you can also land on planets and get out of your ship. I think that aspect should be any video game ever that has interspace travel. You should always be able to land on planets. Anyway, that's my word on that. Oh yeah, in the middle of their press event, they had an announcement for Shenmue 3, and people lost their shit for that as well. That I don't understand. I know nothing about this franchise. But they also said that they're starting a Kickstarter for it, and that if we want it developed, we had to pay for it, basically. This I don't like. This is Sony, one of the biggest companies, going on stage, and one of their developers asking for money. Pause for dramatic effect. Yeah, that's bad. Why would a developer be getting on stage to ask for money? Sony, you have some questions to answer. Give your developers money, and they'll make games. Don't make them ask the fans for money for games. It's a bad idea. I don't want E3 2016 to be Kickstarter E3, so please cut that shit out. They next announced a media player, I believe, for the PlayStation 4, including a PlayStation View, kind of a TV service for PlayStation members and people who aren't Plus members as well, so that's kind of cool, I guess. Shouldn't that have been there from the beginning? I don't know. Anyway, what else did they announce? I didn't get the name of the game. Oh well, it was a game where you make dreams, basically, and you puppeteer those dreams around. And apparently you can create these dreams with other people and work off their ideas and stuff like that. Any kind of creation game always kind of strikes my interest, and this game looks really kind of cool if they can do all the things that they say they can do. So other than that, it just looks also kind of creepy. Puppets creep me out, so I don't like puppeteering things. Anyway, that looks kind of cool. Oh yeah, that's made from the makers. It's being made from the makers that also made Little Big Planet, so it'll have those kind of aspects to it. They also announced two games that it will be coming from PC onto PS4. They include Kerbal Space Program. Woot woot, that sounds awesome. Can't wait for that. And also they announced The Deep, which is like a sharks versus humans team deathmatch game. Really cool. Really spooky game. I hate sharks, so the game The Deep always like freaks me out. One day I might play it on the channel or stream or something like that, because it looks really cool and I'd like to get more people to play it. But yes, what else did they announce? They announced Uncharted 4 was their final video of the event. Something really funny when I watched that, they had some fuck up. The controller died on the presenter as he was about to do the gameplay footage. And they just restarted the game. Like, the cutscene started over and everything. And at the end of the Uncharted gameplay thing, it cuts to the guy who's playing, and he just puts his head in his hands and then stands up real quick and then walks off stage. And that's it. They cut the lights on and they end feed. And I was like, are you fucking kidding me? A developer as big as... Whoa, map cutting in and out. Damn console. Anyway, a developer as big as Sony just letting the ball get dropped that much? Holy shit. No goodbye, thanks for joining us. No, oh, look at all these awesome games kind of clip montage thing like every other developer. Whoa! Oh my god! There's a guy trying to kill me! Anyway, yeah. Every other developer had like some awesome B-roll with, not B-roll, some awesome like kind of thing where they showed off all their games. So why Sony just cut to nothingness, I don't know. Thank you, XX High Peewee. That's always appreciated. Anyway, yeah, the fact that Sony this big just kind of let the show end like that is like, ugh, come on guys, try harder. Anyway, yeah, that was the end of the Sony press event, and that ended day zero. And then the E3 event actually started, and so did Rooster Teeth's live coverage from the event, which was really good. I watched all of that, and I would recommend you to watch it online if you could, but sadly, I don't think those videos exist, so I'm kind of glad that I watched it almost every minute that I possibly could, and just had it playing on my phone while I was doing normal everyday things, because I figured out this really nice app that allows me to play YouTube with my screen off. YouTube, please get around to making your app do that, but I hate downloading a third-party app just to do that. But yeah, I watched a lot of the Rooster Teeth streams, so a lot of the news after these press events I learned basically from them. So we move on to Nintendo, which had their event day one of E3, which, Nintendo, bad time to have your press event. Hold it beforehand so people coming to your booth know what the fuck's up. Anyway, I just really don't have anything good to say about the Nintendo press event. It looks bad. It looked awful. Every 20 minutes they had people talking in Japanese and had to be dubbed or subtitled for like 30 minutes each. This is ridiculous. Like, the monologue bits were so long. So, Sony, you dropped the ball there. Or not Sony, I'm sorry. Nintendo, you dropped the ball there. Anyway, the games they announced were lackluster at best. Splatoon struck my interest, and I was hoping that they would have more things like that, but they're not. They're basically, they announced a new Star Fox game, which looks like N64, but shittier. So there's that. I'm gonna jump off this bridge and hopefully not die. Would I die from that? No, I won't die from that. No, okay, good. If I'd landed on my head, I might have died. But anyway, yeah, the new Star Fox game looks really bad. It looks like N64. And the developers say that my car is... Whoa. Ah! What the fuck is going on here? Shake that thing out. Yeah, there you go. Okay, anyway. The developers say that the Star Fox game looks so bad because that's what they have to work with when they're trying to get 1080p 60 frames a second. I'd like to call bullshit, because Mario Kart 8 looks fucking gorgeous and it runs 1080p 60 frames a second anyway. So where's your excuse now? Anyway, moving on from that, they have a new Metroid game for DS, I think. Might be for Wii U, who knows, but you can't play as Metroid. And the reception to this release, whatever, has been so bad that people have made a petition to stop development of this game to put the developers on other games that they might want. So, again, Nintendo, what are you doing? They also announced a new Animal Crossing game that I think has amiibos, so more amiibo sales. Nintendo knows that market well, that's for sure. And I briefly saw something also that had a cross between Skylanders and Amiibos, and I don't buy into any of these little toy kind of video game crossover things, but I know it's a big market, especially the collectible side of Amiibos. It's huge, and to make that also with the Skylanders collectible things is just as huge. So that actually sounds like the best thing from the event for them to make money on. Other than that, there was this game called Hyrule Warriors for the DS. It's like Zelda Hyrule Warriors Legends. So, yeah, there's plenty of DS games, not so many Wii U games. So that's basically all I have for the Nintendo press event. It was not so great. Anyway, and we'll move on to the next event that day was the Square Enix event, which I actually didn't get to see this event, but it does exist on the YouTube space. Just go search it out and you can watch it. But I just know some of the key games that were announced that day was Just Cause 3. I watched the trailer for that, and I saw Nerdcube's reaction, of course. So I am extremely excited about that game. It looks fucking good. It's like everything I loved from Just Cause 2, plus something extra. They have a fucking wingsuit. No just grappling hook and parachute anymore. You get to fly around in a wingsuit, which is awesome. Cannot wait for that. But yes, other than that, they announced a new Deus Ex game. Don't have much to say on that. It's just an honorable mention, I guess. Why make a new one? I don't know. Because people made fun of the last one so much. I don't know why they would make a new one. Anyway, another game they announced was Kingdom Hearts 3, which is huge. A huge announcement. People lost their shit for that. Yeah, I'm very excited for that, I guess, just because I know a lot of people that really love that game. And it's not just like a diehard love for like the game itself, it's a love for... Hey, fuck you, guy. It's a love for the lore of the game, it's a love for the story, it's a love for the background, it's a love for everything connected to the word Kingdom Hearts. So just to be announcing a third one means big bucks for whoever's putting it out. So thumbs up Square Enix to that. I think that was announced by them, at least I really hope so. Another thing they also announced was a Star Ocean game. So another JRPG. I probably won't be playing that, but I know my buddy Corey will. Shout out, Corey. So, new JRPGs. Woot woot. After that, they had another press event, which I wouldn't exactly call a press event. It was the PC Gaming Show, put on by... I'm pretty sure this is the guys who put out the magazine, PC Gaming. So... a magazine company having a press event? What? Anyway, I didn't get to watch the whole thing, but you can see snippets of it almost everywhere. But the main highlights they announced... I only have one game listed here that interests me, and that's American Truck Simulator. Woohoo! But when I googled it, it turns out they announced this game a long time ago anyway, so I just missed that whenever that happened. But yeah, that's the thing, American Truck Simulator. If you like Euro Truck Simulator, you're gonna like American Truck Simulator. America. Anyway, yeah, the event was hosted by Day 9, which is cool. Really cool in itself, given that I know very little about a lot of the PC gaming things and stuff like that, but I did know who Day 9 was, so I was like, hey, I know this guy, what's up? But it turns out to be some weird Conan O'Brien spinoff, quoting Nerdcube there again, just because I recently watched his Soup of the Day where he talked about E3, and I took a lot of notes for this video that I'm doing right now. So yeah, the event was really weird. It had a couch in the middle, and Day 9 would have people come on, and developers would talk at length about the game that they were developing, and then show very, 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 very short trailers. Like, I was really surprised at the American Truck Simulator trailer. It's like a minute and 11 seconds, and really doesn't look that good. It looks bad. Like, it looks like Euro Truck Simulator 2 running at normal settings. Why wouldn't you make the trailer in ultra settings? CSC, what are you doing? Anyway, yeah, other than that, I have no other games that were announced there. Just nothing. Other than, like, I think No Man's Sky was announced for PC, which is kind of like, duh. Shouldn't that have already been on that list anyway? Anyway, What else? Oh yeah, there was a guy who yelled Half-Life 3 from the crowd. He deserves all the lols just because that's what we wanted to hear at kind of a press event centered around PC. That's what we would want to hear. I actually was really surprised that Steam didn't have a press event. I mean, they've got all these games and they sell all these games and games. Why? Steam, why? Why were you not there? Anyway, I did read a comment in the comment section of the PC Gaming Show's comments where it said if Half-Life 3 was going to be announced, Gaben would not be here for that shitty of a screen. Like, the screen that they had to show the trailers on was like a 72-inch television, and that's it. To give you some retrospect, the Microsoft press event, I think, was held in a football stadium. And the Bethesda press event was held at, like, some extremely famous theater in Los Angeles. I think it's, like, the theater that has, like, the weird Chinese theme outside of it. The one that's in GTA 5. Like, I could drive to it now. Actually, I'm going to. Yes, but let's continue. Is it right? Is it here? Is it right here? I think it's right here. No. Is right here. Anyway. Yes. That's all I have to announce from the PC Gaming Show. Other than that, please try again next year, PC Gaming. You dropped the ball. Other than that, I have some things that aren't really tied to consoles, but just games that have announcements that are worth a mention. Destiny has a new DLC coming out soon, where they have new achievements, so great for Xbox players. Also new subclasses, which is great for all players. Really cool. They made the Warlock into Palpatine. He can just shoot fucking lightning from his hands. That's cool. Can't wait for that. And also, a bad side of the DLC is it's going to cost $40 if you don't have the Season Pass. But actually, I don't even know if the Season Pass thing is relevant, because I didn't hear anybody talk about it. People just kind of carried on like it was a normal thing. The information that I kind of want to know is this going to be included in the Season Pass or not? And if so, does that mean the Season Pass is now over and you're going to have a Season 2 Pass? I really don't know how the people want to do this, because on the Rooster Teeth Live... Whoa, hit the mic. Terribly sorry. Hate that. Anyway, Rooster Teeth had the developers of this new DLC on stage to talk and play Destiny with them, and it's the Rooster Teeth team played Destiny in the background while they talked about it, and I didn't hear any of those people have as much fun as they had all day while playing that game. It was Bernie, Gavin, one of the Rooster Teeth live action people, Colton, whoa buddy, and somebody else, Adam Kovic? Yeah, Adam Kovic was there. So that was just an awesome part of the stream to listen to. That was really good. So if anything, I'd like to play this DLC just because I listened to them having so much fun with it. Not to mention the new achievements, the new subclasses. There will also be new game modes, one which includes a mode where your super charges really fast and your grenades charge really fast, everything charges really fast, heavy ammo drops drop quicker. So that is, it's called Rampage or something like that, starts with an R. Reckless, I don't know, but that game mode sounds really cool and I cannot wait for that. Yeah, and the Destiny guys on the stream were grade A, so thumbs up to Rooster Teeth for bringing me that content. That was really good. That was actually earlier today. The day I'm recording this was Thursday. Yeah, today was actually day 3 of E3. That's why I'm bringing you all this information. It's the wrap up of E3. But yes, other things that I saw on the stage that Rooster Teeth had set up is the YouTube E3 gaming stage. It was really cool. They had both of the rhythm gaming franchises are back this year. There is a new Rock Band game. There's a new Guitar Hero game. So I'll let that sink in for a little bit. It's been years and years, and they fucking decided to bring the games back, but who knows. But the Rock Band 4 have some interesting, juicy information that you guys might want to know if you're interested in it at all. All DLC bought on the PS3 and Xbox 360 versions will transfer over to Rock Band 4, which will be coming, I think, end of this year. So that's really cool, especially for all the people that I know that have spent a shit ton of money on the game. And I don't know where I'm driving to because I set that waypoint and didn't even go there. Just now noticed that. I'm gonna drive there now. Anyway, Rock Band 4 also announced that all your guitars from past gen consoles and all your drum sets, all your microphones will be usable with special dongles, as the developer called it. Dongle, I love that word. So you'll have to buy these special dongles, but you can use your old equipment, and the new equipment will just be cool, so that's awesome. What I don't understand, though, is the new Rock Band guitar, it has 10 buttons, and if I remember correctly, the Rock Band 3 guitar does not. So how they expect you to use that guitar to do the updated Guitar Hero stuff, Rock Band stuff, is beyond me. But yeah, I mean, that's kind of cool. They also have this weird new solo section, which Guitar Hero had, like, a section where you could do a solo, and it was just button mash, button mash, button mash, get a bunch of points, and then hit one final note, or two or three final notes, which if you didn't hit those notes, you were like, fuck, shit! So, it's different now. It has, like, it's like a guided solo. So it'll say, play some high notes here, play some low notes here. So that's kind of cool. I'm excited to see what people will do with that and if they'll be able to make recognizable music. So that's about all I have to report on Rock Band 4. But of course, Guitar Hero Live was announced a little earlier this year, and they showed more gameplay for that. But they also said that their DLC would be transferring over and that they will be issuing dongles to help users play old equipment on the new consoles. So that's kind of cool. Oh, dropped the controller. Oh, jumped out of my car. No, why? Shit. My car just rolls down the road. Fuck it, I'll stroll down there. Anyway, that's the rhythm games are now back and are in full force. What is going on here? What the fuck, guy? Anyway. Yeah, those look like, you know, games that I played years ago. I don't know who in their right mind is going to buy them, but somebody might, and more power to you. But yes, other than that, another gigantic name in gaming was announced. I think it was actually announced at the Sony conference, but it's being released for all consoles, so I've listed it under Other. But Black Ops 3 was, they showed gameplay trailer and stuff like that, so I'm really excited for that. The story mode doesn't look that interesting, but the gameplay trailer, you should Google the gameplay trailer or look in the description for me to put it in there, because it is so good. It's like a montage trailer. It's so fucking good. It shows off like different classes, and then that character dies and it switches to the class that killed him and shows off that. Not to mention, the video flows perfectly with the music and the gameplay. Everything just flows perfect. And just the shit they showed was really good looking. All the normal kind of things you'd expect from a Black Ops title are back. Things like Bloodthirsties and assassinations and stuff like that, headshot medals and stuff like that. Love it. I'm still not driving to my waypoint. I'm a fucking idiot. Anyway, let's see. What else? Yeah, Black Ops 3 looked really good. Not only can you play as humans, you can play as a robot, apparently, because the final mic drop in that gameplay multiplayer trailer was a robot comes through the smoke and just like mows somebody down with an assault rifle, and then like drops his assault rifle like a fucking mic drop, and pulls out, hit like just puts his arm up, and his arm turns into some, like, Star Wars-style Gatling gun and just, like, starts raping face. It's really cool looking. Here we are at the Oriental Theater. All right, whatever. But, yeah. My car is so dirty. But, yes, what else do we have? A Jurassic World Lego game was announced on one of these days and then was available for download. So, I love it when developers do that. More power to them. Another Lego game that was announced was Lego Dimensions. It's a portal-based Lego game. So, that's cool.
See you at the knitting circle!
What? Anyway. I'm pulling out my gun because I don't feel safe standing here. I just noticed that guy standing behind me. I married my dad. Sequel to. Anyway, the Jurassic World Lego game. People have been playing the shit out of that. Lego Dimensions, which is a portal-based Lego game. People will be playing the shit out of that as well. Also, something they showed in that trailer was this little almost Skylander Strike Force style thing where you put your Lego people and they do different things on the screen. So that I'm not excited for, but that's a thing. More power to you guys. So if you can make that a thing and start selling amiibo style Legos, oh my god. Oh my god, all the money you'll make. But yes, another game that I feel like deserves an honorable mention but was not talked about at E3 at all is the new Lego game for Steam. I forget what it's called. I think it's called Lego World, but I'm really not sure. It looks really good. If you haven't seen it, I'll link Nerdcube's video on it because he does it perfect justice. But yeah, that is actually all I have to report upon. That was about an hour. It's pretty good. 4 days, so many days of EA content dwindled down into an hour and 10 minutes. I don't know how you can beat that, internet. I do not know how you can beat that. And we end the video here at the Chinese Theater in Los Angeles, where all these press events kind of happened around. Of course, as you know, E3 is in Los Angeles, so yeah, kind of a fitting game to talk about E3 in. It's really cool. Something I didn't see any word from anybody at Rockstar during E3, so if you were expecting me to report something on that, I didn't overlook it. It's just not there. If Rockstar had a booth, they didn't talk to anybody on livestream at all for me to hear about it. So, yeah, that's sad. No Red Dead Redemption 2. Nothing weird like that. But yeah. Yeah. Let's see if I covered everything. Bethesda, Fallout 4, Fallout Shelter is on iOS only, and you can download it right now. Elder Scrolls card game looks really cool. $150 Xbox controller. Who cares? Backwards compatibility. People, please go vote on what games you want to be transferred for backwards compatibility, because they're wanting us to talk about this and wanting people to vote on things. So I'm doing it right now. Go vote. I'll put that in the link dump if I can. Mods for Fallout 4. Oh, I didn't talk about this. During the Microsoft press event, they announced a weird remake collection of games that is called the Rare Rewind. Yes, I'll say it like a pro. But that game will have 10,000 gamer score. You didn't hear me wrong. 10,000 gamer score. Not only that, but if you played Perfect Dark Zero and you got all 1,000 of those, when that game pops up, you'll have 1,000 gamer points already. Any of the games that are in this collection, which I think has 10 games? I'm not sure. But they all have 1,000 points tied to them. It's insane. It's fucking insane. Oh, look, there's my car. But yeah, another game that's included in that Rare Rewind is Battletoads. So you can now effectively call GameStop and ask them about Battletoads, and they won't just hang up on you. So that's cool. That's a thing. Ark Survival is coming. DayZ is coming to Xbox One. There's a Hitman game. I don't know if I talked about that or not. That might be for all consoles. Looks kind of cool if you like Hitman. Yeah. There was Mirror's Edge Catalyst. I don't think I talked about that. new Mirror's Edge game. It's kind of cool. Let's see. South Park, Fort Honor, Assassin's Creed Syndicate, the Horizon game, The Last Guardian. Fallout. No, not Fallout. What is it? Final Fantasy VII. Yay. Has a remake. Yay. I don't play Final Fantasy, but I know people are really excited for that. Kerbal on PS4 is really cool. Yeah. That's that. Star Fox, about the only title that really makes me go, on Sony, or Nintendo. Damn, sorry. Just Cause 3, highlight of Square Enix. The PC Gaming Show, the American Truck Simulator was the highlight. And Guitar Hero and Rock Band thingies and Black Ops 3. So, yeah, that is really all I have to report on. And I'm tired. I'm worn out. That was a long list. Shit. All the ice has melted in my sweet tea. No. But yes, it's now extremely hot here in my room because I had to turn off the AC to record this. But, yeah, I'm going to go turn my AC back on and start editing this video and try and get it out for you guys tomorrow. But, yeah, if you want to leave any questions or comments you have, please do so. Please hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and check out the IRL channel as well. I love all of you guys. And, also, if you notice that I've misreported on something, please let me know so I can, like, say something about it in the description so people don't fucking burn me at the stake. So, yes. Yeah. I really don't know what else I have to say anymore. Feels good making an hour-long video. But yes, guys, have a wonderful day, and if you want to ask me what my favorite game is, I believe my answer will probably have to be, I don't want to say American Truck Simulator, but it might just be American Truck Simulator. Yeah, it's really between Black Ops 3, American Truck Simulator, and what was it for Microsoft that I really like? Well, it wasn't from Microsoft, it was from Sony. It was the Horizon game. Believe it or not, a PS4 game is on my top list of games. So, yeah, that's that. Guys, again, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and favorite. And also check in the description for links to all the videos and conferences I talk about so you can get your own scoop and develop your own opinions and see all the trailers for yourself. But yes, I am fucking beat. I am fucking thankful that E3 is now over. Woohoo! But yeah, I'm glad I didn't even have to like work a booth, but I still feel like I worked a booth this week. I watched so much fucking stuff, so much. I'm just glad I didn't have to walk from all of the damn things. But yeah, guys, I'm just blabbering on here. I'm going to end this video here. I love every single one of you. Go have a wonderful day. Ta-ra.